Doctors, like any individual, can sometimes make for particularly difficult patients. Doctors indeed can make difficult patients due to their background knowledge of medical conditions, and because of this, they may be more prone to getting over-analytical or micromanagerial. This thought process can sometimes make them question the diagnosis or treatment plan offered by the healthcare provider, and it's for this reason that they often, or better said, we, might be perceived as demanding or challenging to treat. Am I a bad patient? I had a surgery on my shoulder 4 weeks ago. Stay tuned until the end of this video to find out if I was a bad patient. Why can doctors be great patients and why can be sometimes really difficult? And what happened in Michael Jackson's case, the most famous case in the public eye? And what was my most recent experience as a patient? Doctors can also be excellent patients. They are usually more knowledgeable about their own health than non-medical patients and can provide valuable insights that can help their healthcare providers diagnose and treat their conditions more effectively. They are also more likely to follow treatment plans given their understanding of the importance of the treatment. Therefore, they may be more compliant with the therapy. Even so, doctors may also complicate the diagnosis and therapy by challenging their doctors with what they have read about their conditions. As such, doctors as patients may even be more knowledgeable and informed, at least theoretically, than their treating doctors, which can result in tensions or delays in treatment until the treatment debate culminates into a practical plan. Non-medical patients may even be in an advantageous position in that they get the standard diagnostic and therapeutic protocols, which are likely to result in a more consistent outcome. You may be surprised to find out that doctors, just like any other patients, may face challenges in navigating the healthcare system. They may have difficulties scheduling appointments or getting timely access to medical care, which can lead to frustration and dissatisfaction with their care and creating a perception of being more difficult. Doctors tend to micromanage. There are also other reasons that can contribute to doctors being perceived as difficult patients. As an example, doctors are often under significant stress and pressure due to their overscheduled and busy work with their own patients, which can affect their behavior as patients. They may be less willing to take time off work to attend appointments or even follow through with the treatment plans, leading to frustrations on the part of their healthcare provider. Is there objective scientific data that doctors make terrible patients? Well, there's limited data that suggests that the idea that doctors make terrible patients is not supported by evidence. A study published in the Journal of General Internal Medicine found that physicians were not more likely than non-physicians to engage in difficult or non-compliant behavior as patients. While the stereotype of doctors being terrible patients may exist, this perception is not always accurate or fair. Like any patient, doctors may face their unique challenges and concerns, and it is important for healthcare providers to approach each patient equally, regardless of their profession or background. Researchers reported that in an encounter with a fellow physician, 26% of doctors would do more investigations, 22% would be more likely to treat, and 46% would be more likely to refer onwards. Many doctors will identify with this finding and will remember consultations where they felt that their clinical judgment and decision-making was influenced by the identity of the patient or by the knowledge of their patient colleagues. Doctors and their family members and friends are all examples of patients with VIP syndrome. That's when a very important person receives a level of care not even offered to the average patient, which may cause the doctors to second-guess their everyday decision-making, potentially leading to mistakes out of the best intention to excel. And indeed, the care of doctors or VIPs is often qualitatively different from that of other patients. There's a risk for both over or undertreating VIP patients, where doctors may try to spare their special patients from embarrassment, pain, or inconvenience, and so might omit some investigations or procedures. On the other hand, the VIP treatment can result in an additional and unnecessary tests, which might not be even in the patient's best interest. Deviating from standard practice may cause tension within the healthcare system as well. There may be delays in treatment as doctors unwittingly collude with the doctor-patient conflicting opinions. As a doctor, should you treat your own family? Well, the need for objectivity when treating patients is the key reason doctors are advised not to treat their friends or families. The General Medical Council suggests that doctors should, whenever possible, avoid providing medical care to anyone with whom they have a close personal relationship. And while an overdose may have killed Mr. Jackson, I would argue that he suffered from another serious health problem, a VIP syndrome. All right, delivering on my promise, was I a terrible patient when I had shoulder surgery? Well, that's the question you should ask my wife, who was my anesthesiologist. Therefore, she violated all recommendations not to treat your family members and took an amazing care of me. She performed a nerve block for pain after the operation and managed my intraoperative anesthesia and postoperative care at home. But by being a doctor, I knew and read a great deal about my condition, rotator cuff surgery, and was able to knowledgeably and unobtrusively participate in my care. Still, you should ask my surgeon as well, Dr. Anne Ludwig, whether I was difficult, but I believe that I was a dream to work with and a compliant patient. In one of the next videos, I will share my full story as a patient, the things that I learned that helped me become a better doctor and caregiver to patients through the experience of my own surgery and understanding the importance of empathy in the clinical care. And if you like NYSORA's videos, be sure to subscribe to the channel and do not miss the next video on this topic. Should you treat your own family members?